So we are talking about occurrence of sulfur as an element, because for it we can find it in earth in combined state, and itself can also form underground deposits. So we are saying a good proportion of sulfur exists as hydrogen sulfide, as hydrogen sulfide in petroleum gases and volcanic regions. So while you have a volcanic region, just know you are going to find a good proportion of sulfur. So the lead 2 sulfide, zinc sulfide, iron 2 sulfide, iron disulfide, all those are ores of sulfur, as we are going to be talking about them. So basically, sulfur has 2 allotropes. Allotropes. So when we talk about allotropes, we say that it is the existence of an element in more than one form, but with the same physical states but different chemical properties. So when we talk about an allotrope, you should know that an allotrope is an element with existing in more than one form or different forms, but with the same physical state. So, i.e., an allotrope is an element existing. In more than one form with the same physical properties, but different chemical properties. So that's what we call an allotrope. So an allotrope is an element existing basically in more than one form, i.e., for the case of sulfur, we have what we call monoclinic sulfur and rhombic sulfur. These are the 2 major forms of sulfur, that is monoclinic and rhombic sulfur. But in some other textbooks you will find talking about plastic sulfur, you will find people talking about amorphous sulfur, but our major forms or allotropes of sulfur we know is monoclinic and rhombic sulfur, as we are going to be talking about them in details. So we are saying sulfur is insoluble in water but soluble in organic solvent. That is a physical property. Sulfur is insoluble in water but soluble in organic solvents such as benzene. We can have carbon disulfide among other organic solvents that we know. But basically, sulfur is insoluble in water. Once you dissolve it in water, it does not dissolve But when you dissolve it in organic solvents like benzene, carbon disulfide, or carbon tetrachloride, or even methyl benzene, then sulfur will be able to dissolve. That's why we talk about solubility part of it, that sulfur is insoluble in water, but soluble in organic solvents. When we talk about water, water is an inorganic solvent. So we say that inorganic solvents, if it is insoluble in water, then it is soluble in organic solvents. Once it is soluble in that, then we can know that it dissolves in organic solvents. Why are we talking about sulfur? Someone might ask, but they are talking about sulfur. Do we need sulfur really? Why do we need to study sulfur at a tender stage of senior 4? Why do we need to study sulfur in senior 3? Why study sulfur? That brings us to a serious subtopic called uses of sulfur. We have seen its occurrence. We have seen where it lies in the periodic table. We have talked about it. The molecular structure. What does it help us to know sulfur? So we talk about uses of sulfur. We need to know, is this fundamentally important to be talked about at this level? Yes, because without sulfur, we do not have certain compounds that are very, very vital. You know, students have developed bias when we talk about chemistry. Student develops bias in senior 1, senior 2, chemistry. They take their interest in other fields, but they forget that this subject is our daily life. When we talk about that, somebody says, no, how is chemistry life? Biology is life. But all these life processes, without chemistry, life would be very, very impossible. These phones we see, whatever we see on this, even this marker I'm using, there is a lot of chemistry that we need to talk about and know, so that when we fall in a certain field, be it photography, be it what, you need chemistry. So why talk about sulfur? Is it very necessary? Yes. So we need to know that sulfur is used in the manufacture, of sulfuric acid. Very, very, very important. Sulfuric acid, because sulfur is the starting material in manufacture of sulfuric acid by contact process. By contact process. We shall discuss the contact process in the near future before we can end the sulfur and its compound topic. So we are saying we also have vulcanization of rubber. Can you do away without putting on shoes? Unless you have been told in the hospital that you are not supposed to put on shoes, but at least you will put on sandals. So we need to vulcanize rubber so that we get rubber, a process which converts the soft pliable rubber, i.e. a process which converts pliable rubber into hard elastic and tough substance which of which motor tires and similar products are made. So you see that now sulfur is very, very important. We have a tree. We are going to discuss vulcanization of rubber in details when we are talking about applied chemistry. So we say that we convert the liquid, which we call soft pliable rubber, that is a liquid, into hard, elastic, and tough substance. where we can even make motor tires and other related products that are very, very, very important. Then we also have spraying and dusting of plants and fruits, thereby preventing the growth of fungus. When we go to the field of agriculture, we are saying spraying or dusting of fruits to prevent the growth of fungus. So sulfur is very, very important in the field of agriculture, that we dust the fruits with the sulfur or spray the fruits with the sulfur to prevent the growth of fungus. You know, the fungal diseases affect really and hit hard the agricultural produce. And in particular, Uganda being agriculture being our major source of income, we need to look at really sulfur. If it can help us from the growth of fungus that may affect the yield of the produce, then that is very, very important to talk about sulfur. We are saying it is used in making calcium hydrogen sulfide, which is used as a bleaching agent in pulp, wood pulp manufacture. Very, very important, because we cannot do away with paper. We need this very serious. Making calcium hydrogen sulfide. Calcium hydrogen sulfide. That is its formula. Which is used as a bleaching agent, a bleaching agent, which you can call a breacher in the wood pulp industry, in the manufacture of paper. You cannot do away with paper, books. Many people have made businesses in making papers and books where we write. So in the wood pulp industry, we use calcium hydrogen sulfide, which is a compound of sulfur, which is a bleaching agent to make sure that those papers are white. We remove that part of yellowish. But after some time, when you expose it to air, where we have aerial oxidation, then that sulfur component comes back in. And you find when you leave a book, for example, we have gone into the lockdown since March 17th, when we are put under lockdown by His Excellency the President. And you find that most students left maybe their books outside the classroom, at their home, at their schools. And by the time they come back, maybe next year or in September, I don't know when the pandemic will reduce, you'll find that that book which was left open was exposed to aerial oxidation. And that means it combines back the compound, and then the whitish part disappears, then we get some yellowish part of papers. That is why we need a bleaching agent like calcium hydrogen sulfate, a bleacher in the wood pulp industry during the manufacture of papers. So we are saying it is also used in the manufacture of dyes. I see people bleaching their hair, manufacture of dyes. You know what they do? We also have gunpowder. Very, very important when we go to the field of security. We need gunpowder. We have fireworks. When we are receiving the new year, we have matchsticks which we use at home. Then we have sulfur compounds and sulfur compounds such as carbon disulfide